And the recent death of a whitefish snowboarder raises questions of tree well safety. MTN's Jack Ginsburg shows us how to stay safe when skiing or snowboarding.
Tree wells generally form when we're getting lots of snow at a quick period. It's basically dry, loose, unconsolidated snow that forms in some of the bases of our trees. Probably one of the more underestimated hazards of skiing in the trees.
A tree well is a void that forms around the base of a tree and can contain low-hanging branches, loose air, and snow. There is no way to tell whether a tree has a well or not, so it is smartest to treat every tree as if it were dangerous. Soylent says if you do get caught, the smallest thing you bring with you that day might be the thing that saves your life.
You know, don't use pole straps. If your hand's in here and you get confined in a tree well, you don't have use of your hands. So you want to kind of keep your hands out of the pole straps when you're skiing in the trees. Have a whistle close to your mouth so that if you were to get in trouble or get into a tree well, you can alert your partner, let them know that you're having trouble.
Both Soylent and the National Avalanche Institute recommend that the safest way to avoid tree wells is by going on groomed runs only. But it's inevitable that skiers and snowboarders will still go through the trees on those powder days. So they had some tips for them as well.
Oftentimes where some of the best powder is in the trees. So some things to think about is use the buddy system. You know, try to keep your partners in sight, be there to aid them, and then they will be there to help you if you get into trouble.
Many times when riders fall into wells, they go face first, and that can be life-threatening as it is nearly impossible to get out without the help of others. Soylent says if you are digging a friend out of a well, ensuring that they have air is the most important step.
If you've got to get your partner out of a tree well, you want to just dig in from the side and expose their face, expose their airway, because basically they need oxygen. They're drowning in deep snow. And the sooner that you can expose that airway, get them oxygen, the greater chance of survival.
Here on Big Mountain, the snow is starting to fall heavily again, so we could see some more wary conditions in the trees in the future. So for skiers and snowboarders, remember to ski with a buddy. For MTM News, Jack Ginsburg reporting in Whitefish.